Now we will solve example 2.1, and let me recite the example. You can see here on the screen as well. The example says, find the electric field a distance z above the midpoint of a straight line segment of length 2L which carries a uniform line charge lambda, and the figure is given in 2.6. So it is like that we are going to find out the electric field at a distance z above a line segment, and the observation point is just above the midpoint of this line segment, and the line segment carries a line charge density is lambda. So we will draw the figure, and then we will go on for the solution of this example in order to find the electric field at the observation point. So let me draw the figure. We are having a line segment, and a line segment is like this. So there is some symmetries involved in this figure, so I will try to draw it correctly. And this is the midpoint of it, and we are going to find out the field exactly above the midpoint. So this is our line segment, which is here. This is the line segment, and above this one, this is our observation point P. Now from this line segment, it is having a length of 2L, and from the midpoint here, this is 0 here, and this is length L, and on this side it is also length L. So if I go from this to this, the length is L and it is symmetric. While the observation point, let me draw a line from here to here. Okay, this one. Now this is the observation point. If I consider this length segment or this length segment, then this will be the length segment is DL, and I will integrate it from 0 to L. So this one side will be covered. Similarly here, if I consider DL, and I will do the same. And this is joining this point, and it is here like this. Similarly, it is here. And now the thing is that we are having, this is the x-axis, this one along the x-axis, and this one along the z-axis. So this is the z-axis, and this is the x-axis. And here, if I consider this line, like the electric field from this point is directed along this, then it goes like this. While the electric field directed from that line segment goes like the same distance here, so it will be somewhere here. And this is the electric field direction. Now look here, that this is distance x, which is varying from 0 to L, and this is tilted r because this is the distance from the source to the observation point, and this distance is distance z here to the observation point above the midpoint. And from here, if I look here, if this is the base, then this is the angle which is made, and this angle is theta, and here the same angle will be here as well. These two angles are the same angles. Now if I look here, then electric field, this electric field is having on this plane two components. One component is this one, which is along the x-axis, and the other component is this one, which is along the z-axis here, perpendicular to this one, and it makes us the angle here. This is the hypod, this is the base, and this is the perpendicular distance. Now from this figure, I can see that if I look on this side, then this side, the angle again here, this angle is equal to theta. Again, it is the symmetric angle here, and it is again having, this is the perpendicular, the component which is the base one. Now this component, if I consider the electric field, then the electric field is in x as well, as means this is in x plus ez in z direction. This is the electric field. This is the electric field which is E, and this is the electric field which is along the x direction. So Ex here, and this is also Ex. Both are in opposite direction to each other, and they are cancelling each other. While this component is enhancing, means it is along the same Z. So far, both this component will go to zero because this component is cancelling here. While this component, the E will come out, the electric field will come out to be 2 times this EZ component, and this is along the Z direction. So keeping in view those things, I can now write the electric field. The electric field is equal, is we have already derived the electric field, and this is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and the source charge. The source charge here, I will write Q. Then if I look over there, then we are having the source charge is lambda, which is the charge per unit length. And then if I write this thing in the form of D, like DE, I will write the charge equal to lambda, means DQ will be equal to lambda times DL. And here this is DE, so we will have DQ over R square, and R square will be equal to this R square, and it will be in the direction of this R unit vector. Now I can write, this implies that DE is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and for DQ I can write lambda DL, while for this one, this will be R square, and this is in R unit vector direction. So this will be lambda DL. Now is DL, I'm integrating along the x-axis, so it means that this DL is the same as DX. So I will replace DL by DX, and the R unit vector, this is along this direction, but we have resolved this into components, and now our field is along the Z direction, and it is 2 times of that field. So I will write, this thing implies that DE equals 2 times 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and then lambda dx divided by R square. Now R square I can write from here I can see that this is distance x, so x square and z square tilted are squared, and from here I can write that r square is then equal to this. And if I look here back to this one, means the thing is not in our unit vector direction, but this is basically in the z unit vector direction, and this is 2 times of ez. So 2 times I have written here, but this is not the z component, so I will write the z component here, and this is equal to 2 times an ez component. This is this along the z axis I am having the base of this triangle. So the base, we know that it will be the ez times, which is here, ez times, or this will be e times of cos of the angle, and then in z unit vector. So I can write that this is z square plus x square, and then for this I can write that this will be cos of theta in the z unit vector direction. So the easy value I have written, this is the easy value, and then cos theta in z unit vector from here, because the x component, the sine component, they are cancelling each other here, and then this is the base component are reinforcing each other, and that's why they are being added, and we got 2 there. Now from the figure I can see that cos theta is equal to the magnitude here. You can see from here as well that this is z over r. Here is theta and there is theta. This is z over r. This is base and this is the high part. So this is z over r, the tilted r, and this is e implies that cos theta is equal to z. And the r value I know from here that r is equal to z square plus x square and square root of this one. So this is z square plus x square and its square root. So cos theta value is this one, and I will just put here. Now I will not write the vector nature because it is understood it is along the z-axis. And from here I also know that sine theta, from this figure, sine theta is equal to, this is z over r, so this will be x over r, or I can write l over r, both are the same thing here. So this is the, as I have written x here, so I will write that sine theta is equal to the perpendicular, and the perpendicular here is this one, and it is x over tilted r, and this is equal to, this implies, means I can write that x over x z square plus x square, and this implies the tangent theta from here is sine theta over cos theta. Sine theta is x over r and cos theta is z over r. Just reciprocate this one and we will get the tangent theta is equal to x over z here. And we also know that the limit of x are actually from 0 to L. So putting all these in the expression, we will get the dE is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and here 2 lambda d x divide by this one, the z square plus x square from here and from the cos theta. So we will have one z here divided by z square plus x square, and 1 over 2 plus 1, it will come out to be 3 over 2. And we are having our expression like this. And now converting this thing into the integral, and this will imply that we have 1 over 4 pi. This means if I integrate this side as well as I integrate this side, then here d will go, and we will have and this is in the z unit vector. So as I have written e in a vector form, so this is in z unit vector form. This implies that e, the electric field, is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and then we have 2 lambda z, an integral 0 to L 2 lambda z here and dx, 2 lambda z and dx divided by z square plus x square 3 over 2. Now we will have to solve this integral. And in order to simplify this integral, just move something out the constant terms from here, and then this thing is equal 2 lambda z here and divide by 4 pi epsilon naught, and then if I take z square common from here, then this z square will, when it will go out, then we will take its 3 by 2 power as well. So 2, 2 will cancel and z cube will come outside. So here I write z cube. And then integral from 0 to L, and we will have 1 over 1 plus x square over z squared whole power 3 over 2 and dx. So this will be the integral that I will going to be I will go to solve. This is the integral that we will solve.